Hello to all my friends around the world. Thank you for joining me. Many people had problems connecting to our live sessions. So what I'm doing, I'm recording this again. So go on to our website and also on Instagram and Telegram, whatever it is. So it will be there. Okay. The session is about introduction to the tenses. I hope you've downloaded our worksheets and our grammar sheet. It will help you. What we've done, we're using this, using 25 years of experience, teaching thousands upon thousands of students from around the world, from many different countries, different ages, all different levels, from beginner right up to proficiency. People taking the IELTS academic courses and exams. In my opinion, many teachers and institutes overcomplicate the process of learning tenses. And they teach them individually. So they say this week, or this week, this fortnight, doesn't matter. We're talking about present simple. So they isolate it. And that causes problems because students naturally want to progress and they want to know the difference. As we go through this, we'll see the problems it causes. So we've put together a few bullet points that I think will help you, and the methods we use at Frisby's College in the Frisby method to help people understand the tenses. This week I've had some wonderful emails from around the world saying that their students had problems learning the tenses. How can we help? How can the Frisby method help? Keep it simple. Let's explore together, shall we? It says the first point, as discussed in previous sessions, it is important to make the students finish their sentences. And the reason for that is they use the time. And that will help them understand the tenses. For example, when a lot of people say, what's the difference between present perfect and past simple? When they say, present perfect is something that happened in the past that affects us today. Yes, sometimes. But what about the fact that my father died 29 years ago? That affects me now. My father died 29 years ago, past simple. It affects me now. I still miss him. So it doesn't work like that, does it? So this is the way we've got to think and encourage our students to think. But if we get them to finish the sentences, as soon as you say yesterday to last week, last year, 2015, it's past simple. We can't use present perfect. So one thing we need to do is get them to finish. Also, try not to let them use contractions at first. Because if we say he's, what does that mean? If I write on the board he's, I say, what is it? And they say, he is. What about he has? Change of tense. He has been to London. Present perfect simple. He is in London is now. It's fact. Present simple. He's been to London. So the contractions can confuse people. Quite often teachers and students will look for key words, key time words, to help them understand the tenses. But these are confusing as well. If we look at the word always, I write on the board always, which tense? And most people say present simple. Yes, in some cases. I always get up at 7 o'clock. Past simple. When I was young, I always got up at 8 o'clock, for example. If you have a boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife, we can say, I will always love you. Future simple. When we look at the situation with the progressive, the continuous, for annoying habits, I'm always talking. My wife will verify that. Martin's always talking. Where's David? He's playing on the computer. He's always playing on a computer. When I was young, I was always playing football. I love teaching. I think I will always be teaching. Present perfect. I have always lived in England. I have always loved music. When Elvis died, he had always lived in America. I don't think I would ever leave England. So when I pass away, I will have always lived in England. When we look at the word for 1 week, for 2 weeks, for 10 years, it doesn't matter. I write on the board, I go to Italy for 2 weeks. And I say to the students, is that a good sentence or a bad sentence? And they'll say, it's bad. And I'll say, why? They say, I should say, I'm going to go to Italy for 2 weeks. I will go to Italy for 2 weeks. Good point. I say, finish the sentence. I go to Italy for 2 weeks every year. I go to Italy for 2 weeks every summer. Then they realise, you can use it in the present simple. I went to Italy for 2 weeks last year. I will go to Italy for 2 weeks next year. Goodbye, I'm going to Italy for 2 weeks. But they're progressive. If you finish your sentences and use the right situation, we can use for with every tense. Think about it. And if anybody wants explanations for this, you can always contact us. And we've got all the sheets for and always to help you to understand it. Remember, we have worksheets for everything. And all our teachers, all our registered teachers, but you can use your unique number to get information and download off our website, which will be an updated at the moment, but in 10 days, it'll be ready. So all registered teachers will be able to download that, download material, like the grammar sheets here. We have grammar sheets for everything, all contained in the Frisby method, all designed by us. We'll talk about those later. For institutes, you can do the same. You can download material using your unique number. Get in touch with us. If you have problems, just contact us directly. Our email address is info@frisbyscollege.co.uk. It says here, if you understand the present tenses, you'll understand the past, you'll understand the future. First thing I teach the students, the Frisby method. Now, with a lot of my students, especially youngsters, we all become time travellers. They swear allegiance to Frisby time travel. And I'm the chief time traveller. And I take the students into the future. And I think, in 10 years' time, what will you be doing? Where will you live? Will you have finished university? How long will you have been working in your job? And then we go back into the past. Go back 10 years. Where did you live? What were you doing? What achievements had you made? And how long had you been studying English, for example? We take them into the future, into the past. Because the functions are the same. We just use the time words to move us forward. Quite often, I write on the board a ticket. And it says to New York. And I say to the students, where can I go with this ticket? New York. Can I go to Rome? No. Can I go to Brazil? No. I can go to New York. Time words are the same. You put yesterday, it's got to be past. this year, present perfect. We have to think of these things. And we have to think of how they go together. It says here, learn how to mix the tenses. Many people say, I know the functions of the tenses, but I don't know how to put them together, how to mix them. That is because we learn them individually. We've got to learn them a holistic way, together. It's no good saying, that's your another lesson. If someone asks you, what can you explain the difference? You've got to explain it to them. Students have these wonderful minds. They hunger for information. Let's give it to them. Let's give it to them in a way they enjoy it and they will understand it. The idea to mix the tenses, put them together. I told you about the ticket to Rome, to New York. Another thing we do, I say, look, I live in Great Yarmouth. If I want to go to Rome, I can't go from Great Yarmouth to Rome. I have to go Great Yarmouth, airport, Rome. Logical. Think of that with the tenses. If I'm in the present and I want to get to the past perfect, I have to go present, past simple, past perfect. No past simple, no past perfect. It's the same with the future. I have to go future simple, future perfect. They go together. Without one, you can't have the other one. With the progressive, some countries, they don't have the progressive tense, so they find it difficult to understand, and also they overuse it. The key to it is, remember, you can't use the progressive on its own. You can't say, I was walking to school. Everyone will say, yeah, and what happened? Ah, I was walking to school and I met David. I was walking to school and it started to rain. They go together, and we've got to teach them as such. The students deserve that. It says here, we do not always have to follow the tenses. What happens is, quite often with the students, you say to them, have you been to London? Yes, I have. Yes, I have been to London. Because they don't realise we can use other tenses, excuse me. Every time we speak, we give a message. We've got to understand the message we want to give. So if we say, have you been to London? We can say, yes, I went to London last year. Finish the sentence. Here, you want to tell them when you went to London. Yes, I go to London every week. You want to use the frequency, every week. The adverb of frequency, every week, every month. I have been to London 10 times. Here you want to say how many times. So we can change, we don't have to follow those tenses. We have to understand that every time we speak, we give that information. It says here, learn and teach by making sure the learner uses full sentences. We spoke about this earlier. Quite often in exercises, it's gap fill. He does, we do. So we say, I, then you have the gap fill to London every week. And you fill in, I go. She, every week. She goes. You have a 50-50 chance. In my opinion, that's not learning. It's just a guess. Let the students, they've got wonderful minds, they're great people. Let them 5 minutes out for themselves. Nowadays, we have, instead of PPP, we have OHE. Observe, hypothesize, and experiment. Let them experiment. So the idea of this is, instead of giving them one word to fill in, which is not really achieving anything, because we want the student to use the word order, create authentic sentences, that's what we need to do. And it says lastly, be authentic and give real life situations. See the present simple worksheet that we've got here. Before we go to the worksheet, let's have a look at different things. People use grammar books from around the world. Fine. Some of them are very, very good. And people have been using them for a long time. So, the idea of it, as I say, it's got to be authentic. It's got to capture the imagination of the student. Make them feel excited. Make them look forward to coming to the lesson. Make them feel happy. Make them enjoy it. Authentic material. That's why at the Frisby method, we get to learn the students. We know what they like. And we choose, we speak to them. In your situation, we would use it this way. This goes for youngsters, it goes for business people. Quite often say, now in your business, you would use it in this way. In your business, you would use it that way. And it's funny, it's because they relate to it. And also, it shows you care because you're talking to them as individuals. Authentic material. All our material has been created by us using authentic means, authentic material. Not prefabricated. So, let's have a look at the worksheet. The first bit is very straightforward. It shows you the positive, contractions, questions and negative. It says here, present simple is used for identification. People don't break this down. I am, you are, we use for identification. I am a teacher, you are. He is David. This is a table, this is a chair, this is a shirt. I hope you like the shirt, Frisby College shirt. Yep, this is a shirt, this is an emblem. And then if you look at it, instead of making them fill in one word, we make them create their own sentences. This is because it gives you the word order. From right from the beginning, they're working in full sentences. The next one's descriptions. Great idea, because there we can start bringing in adjectives. The weather is beautiful. Not in England, I may add. Not especially at the moment, but the weather is beautiful. Here, then this is the way we can expand on it. By when we say the weather is beautiful, we can look at word fields. It's warm, it's sunny, it's hot, it's bright, etc. So in this, with this here, it's not just writing a sentence. It says here, number 5, they are happy. Here we can do word fields with emotions. They are sad, they're ecstatic, they're funny. So here, it's not just writing one sentence. Susan is Italian. I am English. Here we do the word fields, building up our vocabulary, widening our lexical range. England, English, Italy, Italian, Spain, Spanish, etc. Iran, Iranian. The great thing about it, we're building our vocabulary as well. The next one, things we usually do, normally do. It says, I go to the swimming pool every Saturday. I usually go. So here, when we got the, excuse me, the adverb of frequency, we can change that. As they can see now where usually goes. I normally. I usually. I sometimes. Or sometimes I go. We start building up the sentences. We're bringing things into it. Excuse me. I get up at 7 o'clock. Here we can use time. We're building our vocabulary with the tenses. And it says here, make a things of list of things you do regularly, normally, occasionally. We're bringing in those modifiers. Timetables and schedules. The bus goes to London at 8 o'clock. The good thing about this is we teach them real life situations. When you go to the train station, you don't say, what time will the bus go? What time will the train go? You say, what time does the London train leave? Because it's a timetable, it goes all the time at that time. We do timetables. This is good for the children as well, because here it says, on Mondays I have history, maths, English. We get them to make up a timetable. In business, we can change this, where we have to prioritise. We have to get ourselves into routines. I get to work, I check the email, I have this meeting. It gets them understanding how we use the present. General information. London is the capital of England. Tiramisu is a traditional Italian dish. Now, I put tiramisu in because I just love tiramisu cake. And for anybody that hasn't tried it, you must. Cars are expensive. When we're looking at this, we can work on the words as well. Cars are expensive. What's the opposite of expensive? People say cheap. No, it's not. It's inexpensive. When we have cheap, we have the collocation of bad quality. So we're playing with it. We're going, giving more information, not just concentrating on the tense. Instructions, recipes, how to send an email. It's important for the students to know that when we give directions, when we give instructions. Now, in this situation, when you're teaching this, what realia should you have? What props should you have? Recipe books, instruction pamphlets from mobile phones, from computers. All these type of things. A timetable from school. Opening hours for the cinema. Get brochures. All these things will show the student how it works. And it's authentic because they'll come across these all the time. And all the time, they're writing full sentences. At Frisby's, we believe we should make lessons exciting, make them fun, and make them authentic. We have some wonderful material. Come from 25 years. I've actually been going for since 1995. Officially, but I was a teacher before that. I was teaching for other people. And that's the reason I became a teacher for my own college, because I thought students deserve more. Now, I know I have met some wonderful teachers over the years, people from Ukraine, people from Italy, all these countries. We got a project in Thailand, and we got projects in other countries. All these people want to give something, and I hope you all share my passion. Anybody that's been to one of my classes know I have a lot of passion for teaching, and I have a lot of passion for helping people. That is why, as I said earlier, you can, as an official Frisby teacher, come onto our website and download material. Download grammar sheets, grammar tenses, conditionals, all things like this, prepositions. It will help you within your lesson. It's used around the world. People in Thailand use it, Italy are using it, we're doing places like this. So what I want you to do is think about that. You can always contact me, send us an email, info@frisbyscollege.co.uk, and any questions. I have questions all the time from teachers. Martin, can you help us to explain this? How would you explain that? No problem, I'll help you. That's what I've been doing for 20 odd years. Anybody that knows me, everybody who knows me for this time will know I'm always there. The worksheets are important. For institutes, using your unique number, you can use our workbooks, our course books. For the children, they can get letters from Sam and Amy, authentic letters from England, with a worksheet so you can actually work on them. It's coming to the end of this broadcast now, and I thank you for listening. I'm sorry some of you had problems listening live. This is why I'm doing this again. A couple of things before I go. Frisby has some great news to share with everybody next week. Very, very good news, and we're very excited. It'll interest all our institutes and people, our teachers, our students. So that's one thing we've got to be thankful for. And something else, what we're going to do, we're going to do weekly tips and workshops on our Facebook, on Instagram, on Telegram. So here's your first thing. Why do we say, I'm going to hospital, or I'm going to the hospital? So what's the difference between I am going to hospital and I'm going to the hospital? Now, you don't have to send in your answers, but I will explain on Monday. And listen out, keep your ears out for our fantastic news and information for so many people. I thank you very much. All the best. Bye-bye.